Are you looking to take your digital art to the next level? Today we're going to be talking about how being story-minded can level up your work. Did you know that digital media designers are expected to have a job growth of more than 24% over the next few years? 24%, that's a huge leap. In this video, I want to talk about how you can stand out from the masses and land better gigs in digital media design. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, being story-minded is what will level up your portfolio and help you stand out from the overcrowded pool of visual designers, digital artists, graphic designers, you name it. There are riches in the niches, as Susan Friedman would say. And you can determine your style and the industry that you wanna play a role in. You will stand out from being a general graphic digital artist. So how does being story-minded really play a role in becoming better? Well, regardless of your niche, applying story to your workflow is more than just a tangible skill. When you look at the idea of story, it's more than just a linear process of fox jumping over bush, but rather an art form in its own right. You see, story in graphic design doesn't have to be linear, which is a perk of non-motion art. Graphic design can tell a story either with one image or a series of images that play a role in a climactic timeline. This image right here of Banksy's shredded art, on the other hand, is just a single image and sold for $1.4
million. Last chance. And selling for $860. Yeah, if you could maybe get one of the technicians quickly to go and take that over there, that'd be great. Quickly. Okay, we're moving on, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to move on here. Sorry, can I have your attention?
As the story itself is in the experience, and funnier that the shredded piece of art is now worth double. Movie posters are also a great example of one image storytelling. Story itself has a scientific structure when done well, and depending on who you talk to, will you get different answers for how many plot points need to be used. A common plot point structure in cinema would be 6, consisting of hook, conflict, initiation, journey, resolution, and jab, which can also be done as a digital artist. The mindset of story is important, as you always want to leave your viewer with meaning. Now, the more minimalist your design gets, the harder this becomes. Whether you are designing images for a product, promotion, information, and especially brands, this is important because your client or piece of work has a message, and some clients may fantasize about this message way more than others. But story is that structure of the message for people to receive or respond to. Think about delivering a package. You see, story is the box embodying the message, and your style and the medium is the messenger. I can't help but share this clip of comparing mail carriers. You see, this is a direct representation of how people associate you, the artist, and how they receive the message. With pristine quality or like a rookie, using and developing your art with story is why professionals are distinguished as professionals. This is so important, as it will take your art to the next level and reveal why you can ask for a higher premium. I mean, along with portraying value, but I've talked about that more in another video called Why 80% of Artists Fail. As you are developing your craft and style with story in mind, will story take you to that next level, giving you structure and connecting meaning to what you're creating? Story, which in return will prepare your creative ability to think outside the box in order to bring your work to life. So what are some practical ways to be able to use this method in your workflow? As the results can be endless, I'm going to give you some examples for illustration graphic design, environmental graphic design, motion graphic design, and I'm going to bundle a couple of them together, which are going to be marketing, web packaging, and visual identity. And the last 4 fall under the bigger picture of branding. there's a story that a company wants to tell us, which identically should be that story you have in mind for the specific project. After establishing who the company is and the message and what they want to tell, you then create the visuals through images, logo, website, packaging, headers, business cards, etc. Companies like Nike, Smartwater, Apple, even smaller companies like Magnolia and Squarespace, which I'm sure you've heard of, are all trying to tell a story. And in some way or another, aiming to engulf their customers into that brand's thick environment of that story. Doing this is not only through commercials, but also in store panels, packaging, through social media, and any place they come in contact with their audience. Now with environmental, motion, and illustration design, would you most likely be designing for companies with an already established brand image or brands that would like to get to that next level of branding? Which isn't always the case, but mostly. As an environmental artist, would you create the atmosphere that embodies the brand's identity in the workplace, trade shows, or public squares, essentially transforming a plain space that represents the company so that the employees and customers feel the brand through their time in that area, leaving them with an experience. I worked on an installation project by Nike back in 2012 for the Olympic trials, and the goal for the installation was to simulate the feeling of movement and speed. There were three different environments installed along with a retail section. In every way, shape, and form was Nike implementing the idea of athletics in their structural and physical design, bringing the audience to interact with who they are and have an experience in their space. Having created the story we all love of being your best in the moment of competition. I mean, as an athletic lifestyle company, they seek to push the boundary of every product they develop for athletes that push every physical and mental boundary to be the best at their sport. This exhibit also embodied the perfect marketing platform to introduce their new shoe with Flyknit technology, allowing customers to interact and buy the shoe before it was even released. There was also a project for Disney California Adventure that I helped install, which honestly, almost 3 months of overnight production, and it was painfully unforgettable. The goal for this project was to appeal and retain a phasing out younger generation by creating a space guided by Tim Burton's Alice in Wonderland, which was actually the first place they started selling alcohol, bringing a rave and electronic vibe. They had a live DJ in the evening, and it actually lasted almost 4 years. If I'm not mistaken, it was a huge success. As an illustrator, I would assume that story is pretty much your basis all the time. So implementing this through graphic design, are you following the storyline or character that is already in place? Most illustration graphic design is created for ad placement that acts as a hook to intrigue viewers to look more into what the ad's actually about. So thinking more like an advertiser might actually be a little bit more beneficial to selling the story through visuals. You see, being story-minded can most certainly take your work to the next level. If you're unsure about what type of graphic design you might want to specialize in, ask yourself some of the hard questions. Why are you in graphic design? You know, what do you want to accomplish? What would you rather work with the team, or would you rather take on more responsibilities? Obviously, if you're a believer, you know, where do you sense God leading you? But I do hope that you found value in this video. I know it was kind of a lot. If you did find value, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe just to stay posted on just the new videos regarding faith and creativity. If you have any questions, like always, please drop them in the comments below. And yeah, that's all I have for today. So until next time, ciao.